foundation ball, raising money for the foundation. It coincides with Frank's 60th birthday, so I thought that's a great excuse to try and raise money.
600, well done, put it on 650.
There is no help at the moment for some thousands and thousands of people in this country with mental health issues. The NHS are struggling with them, other charities are struggling as well, and they are referring them to us. We've got a slightly different way of doing things and helping mental health. We haven't got all the answers, but what we're doing is working for us. And when you get letters, people thanking you for what you've done, it really means something to you.
Yeah, well, I've known Frank since 1971, when I turned pro in 71 down in London. That's great what he's doing, as he was as a great boxer, and when he won the title, overcoming adversities before that, and then the great challenge of trying to win the world title, as he did, and what he's using it for now in the foundation, helping people who are less fortunate than ourselves.
I'm really sorry I couldn't be there for your 60th birthday. Remember when we met and I was like, what, 16, 15? Wow, look what time done to us. Man, we're still breathing, thank God.
Happy birthday, Frank. 60 years of only catching up with me. Have a really fantastic time with your family. Lots of love to you all. And have a marvellous, marvellous day. All the best, mate. Lots of love and
bye. Hi, Frank. It's your mate Rick here. Just want to say a very, very happy 60th birthday to you, my mate. As so many, you were my hero growing up, and you still are, Frank. And what an inspiration you've been to all of us and everyone in life, you know. That if at first you don't succeed, keep trying, you'll eventually get there. And that's what you did when you won that world heavyweight title. I wish you all the best. Have a wonderful night, Frank, and I can't wait to see you soon. Love you, big man.
Frank's such a phenomenal individual who deserves to sit back and look at the 60 years and I hope he looks back and looks on the good he's done. It shows that there's people out there that care most of all. People who are successful in their own lives and don't have to be here, don't have to be helping other people, but actually want to help other people.
Trained in dealing with this, but what we're trying to do is to create an environment, a centre where people can go to try and help combat their mental health. And if we can do that, we'll never solve all the problems, but if we can do a little bit of it and we can save 20, 30, 40 people from committing suicide, we're doing a great job.